holy bar. Now, I say each workout that posture matters in bar. A lot of what we do, the moves that we go through and the various exercises and different things, our entire posture really plays a huge role in how effective that move is, but also in preventing injury and working on our balance and increasing flexibility. Posture matters. So as we go through today's workout, I want those shoulders back. I want that chest forward, your gaze forward as well. We need to be able to see your eyes through all of this. Our core is engaged. The entire barre workout is an ab workout because we use our core for the stability as we move through different movements. And we often say the belly button is pulled back to the spine. I also like that your knees, these joints are soft. We rarely lock those joints. But there's various aspects of our entire body and the posture that we hold throughout this workout that makes a big difference. But ladies, our spiritual posture is even more important as we move through our day. Now, while our physical posture impacts our physical health, our spiritual posture is even more valuable to our wellness and our true desire to be healthy and whole and holy. And so whenever we walk through and we approach each day, I pray that our spiritual posture is one that is looking up, our gaze is up to our Heavenly Father, that we are standing firm in His truth, and that that belt of truth is wrapped around our waist as we are engaged in His Word. And so one scripture that I want us to focus on before we jump into this workout is Psalms 34:5. Those who look to Him are radiant. Let's just pause on the word radiant. That is such a beautiful word. It's always been one of my favorites where you just think, yes, radiant. Radiant is such a good, joy, peace-filled phrase. And the idea of it is that our Heavenly Father is saying we are radiant when we look to Him. When we cast our gaze up to our Heavenly Father, we are radiant. Their faces are never covered with shame. So two thoughts on that. Never covered with shame. Oh, what freedom would that be if all shame and guilt, we were just free and that is washed away from our faces as we keep our gaze up to our Heavenly Father. But at the same time, the Hebrew word for face, a lot of times you see in scripture, is not just the physical appearance, but they use the word face to talk about who the person really is. So not only are our faces radiant, and our faces are never covered in shame, but our souls are radiant. Our souls and who we are never covered with shame. So let's keep a posture that is radiant, that we look up, regardless what's going on around us, we look up to our Heavenly Father, or maybe we bow down. Maybe it is an act of humility and prayer, and we need to bow down and just surrender to our Heavenly Father. But whatever it is, we are not overwhelmed and focused with the things around. Now, another thing is, so I just read Psalms 34:5, which is, those who look to Him are radiant, their faces are never covered with shame. Oh, just love that. But the verse right before it, verse 4, I sought the Lord, and He answered me. He delivered me from my fears. So again, in order to have the radiant faces and the radiant souls, we seek the Lord. We seek the Lord in all things. We seek Him first. We go to Him first. Before we Google things, before we talk to our friends about stuff, we go to the Lord first. And that is our firm foundation where we stand. And then verse 7, so just two more past it. It says, the angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear Him, and He delivers them. Ladies, the idea that the angel of the Lord is there to protect us. So it's one that whenever we get overwhelmed with everything going on in our days and our worlds and our families and our kids and our marriage and different things and the stuff that can just feel so heavy on our soul and weigh us down and just have that look that we are just stressed, that those, my husband will come home from work and be like, are you okay? Because he can tell in my face, my countenance, I am just struggling. But the Lord wants us to have that radiant, that face that doesn't have any shame, it doesn't have any guilt. We just seek Him and He removes all our fears, all our anxiety. And as we seek Him and as we are radiant, And we are in a posture of love, looking up, engaged in His truth. There's also an angel of the Lord around to fight for us, to protect us, because the battle belongs to the Lord and no one else. So as we jump into this workout, you just need light weights. We're gonna have fun. It's just gonna, I think it's like a 36-minute playlist. But focus on your posture. But may, as we talk about our physical posture, may we just translate that over and over. I want us to be transformed in the renewing of our mind, where we take it a step further, where we know that our bodies are just temples and we need to offer them as a living sacrifice. And so whatever that looks like, as we hold a pose and engage our core, that we are thinking how we can do that in a more deeper, eternal, spiritual way throughout our day as well. So let's go to Him in prayer, and then we'll jump into this workout. Heavenly Father, we praise You. We praise You that You fight for us, that You have our best interest at heart, that You love us unconditionally, that You want us to have the freedom of without fear or shame or guilt, and You desire for us to be radiant. You desire for our souls to burn bright for You, and that You equip us with all that we need. Lord, help us to just go to You. Help us just to surrender our posture to You, knowing that You are in control and You will take care of us. Heavenly Father, just we praise You for healthy bodies that we can move through this workout. May we burn bright physically for You, but also spiritually, emotionally, mentally. Lord, we ask that You clear our minds, You calm our souls, You fill our hearts till they overflow, and You strengthen our bodies. In Your precious name, amen. Okay, let's get started. I want you to have your feet just about hip distance apart. We're just gonna start with some basic squats. Now in this squat position, you're standing up through those heels, so your hips are being pushed back. And hold it here. In this position, spread those toes apart. Your upper body is tilted forward slightly. Core engaged, belly button pulled back the spine. Roll those shoulders. We get deeper with each pulse. 4, 3, 2, and hold it here. I want you to raise those arms. Lift those palms to the heavens. Just take a moment, say a quick prayer. Turn over the stresses on your mind. Lord, just clear our minds as we go through this. May we focus on You. Give those hips a little deeper. A big inhale, big exhale, and we move into it. Keep breathing, ladies. 4, 3, 2, and 1. March it out. Let's speed it up. I want you nice and warm before we move into this. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take those legs apart, side to side. Start a little not as deep, and then with each one, dip further. As you get deeper, your hips are gonna go back. We never want these knees to go over our toes. So that's why you shift your hips back. I want you to get deep now. We're really stretching these hip flexors. Four, three, two. Let's stay over here to the side. Pulse it down. Yes, get deep. You can feel it all through that hamstring, this quad, even that back glute, feeling it, right? We're getting warm. 4, 3, 2, other side. four, three, two, one. Let's heel toe those feet together. Take one foot back. We're gonna be in this lunge, hands lifted. As we're here, stretching that hip flexor again. Deeper, now chest is forward, ladies. Posture, right? Core tight, reach high. Four, three, two, and open it up. Sway forward and back. Really get those hips. Stretch. Back. Forward. Back. Four. Three. Two. And stay forward. Bring that back arm. I'll turn to the side so you can see. We're going to be deep. Shift that weight into that front leg. Hold it here. Option. Stay here. Just sinking in deeper. Lift that back leg cover or raise it as high as you can where you feel that glute tighten the hamstring. Pause here, belly button pulled up, core engaged. Four, three, two, and take it back. Look up again, four, three, two, and raise up. I want those legs straight, arms out. Shift forward, triangle. Yes. Four, three, two, and reverse it. Bring it back. Nice. Now let's switch and do the same thing on the other side. Other leg back. Extend those arms high. Really stretching that hip flexor, core tight, and we open it up. Forward and back. Four, three, two, stay forward. Shift that weight in the front leg. Option here, here, or here. Balance challenge. Stability, core, balance. Inner injury prevention. Four, three, two, and one. Stand up tall. Nice work. Let's grab those weights. We're going to come back down to this wide second position. My knees are over my ankles. Roll those shoulders back. Back is upright, core tight. We pulse it down, get deeper, pressing those knees back and out. Toes at 10 and 2, 45 degrees, as if you're seeing it on a clock. You got it. Let's sink it down, hold those legs still. We're gonna move right into the arms. We punch it forward. And we do a nice rotation with each punch. Control movement, ladies. This isn't cardio kickboxing. We take it to the side. Cross, cross. Give us a nice rotation around our waist. That helps with all those organs in there that tend to get carry a lot of the stress. Nice little twist will help those out. Let's take the knee with us. Woo! Stay low. Don't stand up on me. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Last time, warming back center pulse. Let's extend those arms out, in, out. Y'all getting warm? Yes. You got it. Sink a little lower in those hips. Now hold it up, down, extend. As you extend up, squeeze those glutes, straighten those legs. You can heel toe those feet a little closer together. You got it. Four, three, two, and one. Lower those arms. Let's bring those feet together. Get in that first position. Sink back down. Posture, shoulders back, chest forward. We're looking at each other, right? Core engaged. We just do bicep curls. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. We're gonna move right into scoops, okay? Up, side, forward, side. Controlled movements. You got it. Keep going. Let's keep them out. Hold it here. You can slightly pulse those hips. Woo! You got it. Four, three, two, and drop them. Now, changing so your toes are facing forward. We're in a wide parallel, like this. Weights in your heels, upper body's bent forward now, okay? Palms face each other. Really try to squeeze those shoulder blades together. Controlled movement. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, palms face behind. Now core is tight. We have to keep that core engaged or you'll put too much pressure on your lower back, okay? Jossie Hank join us. He's our mini Bernie Doodle. Real good pup. 4, 3, 2, stay here. Come on, we extend and down. Extend, come on. We're getting the backs of those arms, those triceps. Woo! 8, keep those elbows high. 7, 6, 5, 4, yes, last one. Back, back. Notice I'm keeping my elbow behind my ribs. The elbow is just a hinge. Just moving the forearms. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold it back there. Lift, lift. Core tight, shoulders back. Weight in your heel. Woo! Palms towards the ceiling. Come on, give me 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Roll those shoulders back. Ready to drop the weights? Okay, we're going to move into a bit of a cardio burst, but also a big balance challenge. So you may want to stand by a wall or chair or something to help you out. Definitely try to do it without touching anything, but there's a good chance I'm going to need to grab something too. So we're going to move into curtsy lunges and then work from there, okay? 4, 3, this leg goes back first. Down, center, down, center. We stay low. I'm not standing up as I transition side to side. Yes. Four, three, stay here and pulse it. More of your weight is on that front leg, but the back is still helping. Core tight, I'm slightly leaning forward. My knees are out to the side. We go down and up, down, up, down, up. Nice. Four, three, two, stay down, hold it here. Extend and back. With that back leg, everything's still on that front standing leg. Feeling it engaged, right? Those muscles are starting to burn. Woo! Y'all wanna speed it up? Yes. Back. Out. Out. Core still tight. Four, three, two, and one. Pulse it here. Final combo, little balance challenge. You can stay here or you just take this back leg out and tap. Or if you want, I'm gonna move into more of a posture positioning thing. Take it down. We tap and we come up and raise. We take it down and raise, okay? Down and up. Down and up. Down. Try to keep that knee out. We're standing up through the heel of this front leg, okay? Keep going. Four. Three, two, last one. Can you hold it here? Let's bring those hands to prayer. Four, three, two, and one. Shake those legs out. If you need a stretch, this leg might be feeling tight, go for it. We'll just come back here to kind of get more cardio in there and get that lactic acid moving. Down, up, down, up. Couple options. Stay here. You can just stay here with me. You can just tap and raise, but we're keeping our gaze forward, right? Don't look down. Or you can hop. As you stand up, jump high. Squeeze those glutes. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Nice. We're gonna come over here. Hold it here. Right here, we're gonna move back into that combo, okay? Just switch sides, other foot's forward now. Keep breathing, grab water at any time. We take it down and up, down, up, down, up. Keep that gaze forward. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. We bring it back down, out and in. Out and in. Y'all ready to speed it up? You got it. Let's go. Front leg's burning. Woo! Come on, you can have fun with it. Keep going. Four, three, two, and one. Y'all ready for the final combo? Whew, now I can touch something. Y'all got it. Okay, again, you stay here. You tap out, or you come up, okay? eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, hold it here. Woo. You got it? Hold it, hold it, hold it. Inhale, exhale. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Lower it back down. Stretch it out. Grab water if need be. We're going to move into some with the backs of our legs. So grab a wall, countertop, whatever to help for balance. We'll start just in a chair position, okay? Right here with the weight in our heels. And we're just going to pulse up through the backs of our legs into the glutes. You got it. Get low. And we hold it down here. Okay? Hold here. Down, up. We warmed up with this in the beginning. We're just going to build upon it. Keep it low. I want you to shift your weight into this front leg. Extend the back leg. Stay here, okay? Keep pulsing and take this leg all the way back. That back leg is straight. We don't want that front knee over the toes or past them. So check your positioning there. We shift our weight forward again. Lift and tap. Lift and tap. Again, you can hold on to something. You can keep your hands out for balance. You can keep your hands in prayer. The point is we want this front leg deep. You want a good bend. Reach around and make sure you feel those glutes tightening as you lift. Keep that core tight. Woo! Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Hold it up here. Pulse this bent leg. Yes. Woo! Little balance challenge if you aren't holding on to anything. But you feel it all through here. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Little combo. We take this leg up, forward, knee lift, and slowly bring it back and extend it behind. Bring it forward. Using those abs to lift that knee up, and then we extend it back. Four. Three. Two. Last one. And extend it back there. We hold it here. Just hold. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Woo! Nice work, ladies. Let's stretch it out. Oh, good song. Marching on. The battle belongs to the Lord and no one else. We just march on. Y'all ready? Let's march on the other side. Okay, let me see, nope, this way. Switch sides. Take that leg all the way back. Y'all got it. Four, three, two, hold it here. Shift that weight forward. We just lift and lower. Again, do you feel that glute, that hamstring as you lift? Core tight, belly button pulled in. Spread those toes apart and that front foot to give you more stability.
shoulders back. Our gaze is still forward. We're not looking totally down.
Four. of it. We're gonna work this outer leg. Real simple, to the front, to the side, okay? Up, to the side. Forward, to the side. Outer rotation, kneecap straight forward. Kneecap here, kneecap here. This standing leg is tall. I'm engaged, standing sturdy and strong, but that knee joint itself is not locked, okay? Controlled movements. You feel it right here as you lift. Keep that core tight. Yes. Try to keep your inner body as straight as possible, okay? Eight. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, last one. Now lift it forward, now keep it up. Tiny little pulses. I know it's burning. Woo, both legs, right? Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Shake it out. Nice work. Same thing on the other leg, okay? Forward, side. Forward, side. Forward, side. Yes. Your love is lifting me. Lift that gaze up, ladies. His love lifts us. You got it? Eight. Seven. Controlled movements. Check that posture. Six. Five. Four, three, two, one more, and stay out to the side. Woo! Pulse. Come on. Almost done, ladies. Keep going. Four. You got it. Y'all ready for the lunges? Yeah, you are. Okay, one leg back. We're just gonna pause here, okay? Both knees are 90 degrees, hands in prayer. Just stay here. Four, three, two, hold it down. Now I want you to extend that back leg straight. No longer in that 90 degree, and we just pulse it. This is the final song, ladies, before this little light of mine, which you know is how I end every workout. So we're gonna breathe, hold these positions. We're still gonna be burning, but we're also cooling down at the same time, okay? Back leg straight, and we hold it down. Okay, extend your hands high to the sky. Roll those shoulders back. Look up. Breathe. Just give me Jesus. Just give me Jesus. And I want you to shift forward. Shift that body, upper body forward. You can see here that I'm shifted forward. Same, lower body's in the same position. Upper body shifted forward. Look up past those fingertips. Hold it here. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, slowly raise it up. Other side. We're going to start 90 degrees. Basic
lunge. Okay? Shoulders back. Nice work today. Keep breathing. May our prayer be just give me Jesus. That's the posture that matters, right? Our eyes are locked on Him. You are radiant. You are radiant and you are a daughter of the Almighty King. If we just keep our posture focused on that, our spiritual focus, the freedom and grace and truth will be there. He gave us the Holy Spirit that's living inside of us and helping us burn bright. Don't do it on your own. Do it with other believers. And just keep your posture and gaze on our good Lord. Straighten that back leg out. Extend your hands up. Say out loud, I am radiant because of you, Lord. I am radiant because of you, Lord. And Lord, your power is made perfect in my weakness. May our face be free from shame and fears. Lean your upper body forward and hold it here. I want you to focus. We're going to sit in silence just for a few seconds. I pray that your home right now, wherever you're doing this, is silent, Lord. Free them from all distractions. But may we also know that God speaks through the distractions. So while we seek quiet and peace, sometimes He's right there in the mix of the chaos too. But right now, let's savor the silence and Lord, fill our souls, ignite a fire so that we feel that radiant glow of your love. Heavenly Father, we praise you. We praise you that regardless what is going on in our homes, in our communities, in our world, that you are almighty and you are in control and we can just look up to you. Your angel is standing guard to protect us. You've equipped us with the armor of God. We can stand firmly on your truth. You are adamant. You are all-knowing. May we just draw close to you. May we feel you. Lord, I ask that you speak to each woman watching this and working out with us right now. May she feel your presence. May she see you move. May she surrender the fears and the shame and the control that she's been holding on to. And may we move forward free and radiant and burning bright. In your precious name, amen. Let's raise up. It's real important to stretch out, ladies. This does conclude the workout, but I want you to stretch. So stay with me. We'll do a couple just standing stretches, but I encourage you to stretch tonight, tomorrow morning.
It is good for your body, but it's also good for your soul to move slowly and stretch and breathe with each thing. We live in such a fast-paced world, but our Lord wants us to be still and know that He is God. So let's take those legs apart, and I want you to just slowly bend forward. Press into the ground, and then slowly raise halfway up, arms out. Exhale as you collapse back down. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, back down. Once more. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, and down. I want you to reach over to that right ankle and extend that same right hand up into the air. Shift your gaze over. Come back to the center. Reach over to the other ankle. Extend the other hand into the air. Come back center. I want you to heel toe those feet together. Slowly rise up. We're going to stretch the hip flexors. One leg crosses over. And we just do that whole side body. We got the hips. This whole region. We're even stretching our arms as we're here. Breathing. Breathing. Switch sides. I want you to take those arms, roll those shoulders back, palms up, palms down, palms up, palms down, stretch. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Take them high, shoulders still down, and walk them back down. For your legs, we're going to go back side to side. Just the way we started, we start high. With each side lunge, we get deeper. We're finishing up here. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Thank you, ladies. Enjoy the rest of your day. Hope to see you back. Check out other Holy Barre workouts and holler if you have any questions or want to connect. Thank you.